Hello friends, and in this video I'm going to give a difference between functional testing and structural testing. Actually, there is a problem that structural testing should be written over here and functional testing should be written over here. That's why I made this. Just exchange this and the difference is this. So first difference is structural testing, it should be over here and it should be over here. So structural testing is to uncover errors occurred during the coding of the program. So like if coding is done, like these are lines of code, so whatever errors are inside this, that are discovered, not the implementation or not what it is doing. But if we talk about functional testing, it's the implementation of requirements, or it's the implementation of that codes, that is the program doing the right thing that it was intended to. The code could be correct, but it is not, it may not be performing that functions that was required by the user. Okay, second thing is it is connected with the both result and process, like whatever will be the process, like how structure is maintained. First it should be coming, first you should place loops, then you should input it, then you should give output, then again you should use loops. So a structure should be like what process is going through, it should be taken care of, as well as what result it is providing each component. But in case of functional testing, only it is considered with is it providing the result we want or not. That's all. And third is also referred to as white box testing. Like if we talk about structural testing, like lines of codes, the programmer or the tester should have the knowledge about the internal structure of program, like what are loops, what structures are used. The tester should have proper knowledge regarding that. Unless and until the programmer will not have, sorry, the tester will not have the knowledge about what program is constructed about, then he will not be able to perform the test. So it is like the internal design, it is like the internal testing of the program. So the tester should have proper knowledge of the coding, which program, or we can say which language is used, and also all the structures regarding that. But if we consider this structural testing, the programmer should not have proper knowledge. Anyone can test, end user can also do functional testing. Anyone with just come with set of inputs and check whether it is giving the desired output or not. It has some features, like it can discover dead codes in program if we do structural testing, and optimization of codes can also be performed. Sometimes we have codes that could be exchanged, or we can replace it so that the code will use less lines, and it discovers this hidden bugs in program, so which were not noticed by developer. So that was all. Thanks for watching.